Showing off your project is one of the most important events in the design phase because it's a make or break moment for your idea. Virtual tours can help with this significantly, especially when it comes to presenting to non-AC people who can't read floor plans as well as you can. In this video, I will be covering multiple ways of creating a virtual tour of your Revit project. We will start with the easiest, the full navigation wheel, then I will show you how to create a walkthrough video, and finally we will be rendering a 360-degree view for the ultimate virtual experience. Let's go! Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. I have my beginner course project here, the office building, the second project, and let's use this for demonstration. And let's first demonstrate the full navigation wheel. Now I'm going to navigate here to the second level floor plan, and it's actually really easy to set up. This is the simplest one. What you want to do is you just want to go here to view and then find 3D view and open up the camera option. Once you click on that, it's going to show this little camera, and then you can place it wherever you want, just like this with the first click. And then you pull out the second click in the direction in which you want to look. So let's say I want to look towards this office like that. I can just pull it out, click, and it's going to create that camera view. Now for each of these views, you can set up your level of detail, you can make it shaded, realistic, however you like. Now in this case, just to keep things simple, I'm going to keep it at hidden line, and then also we can introduce some shading. So let's try this. Okay, this is a bit too much. Okay, this kind of works. Okay, so now for the full navigation wheel, what you want to do is you want to go here off to the side. It's going to say full navigation wheel. You click and it's going to show this wheel that's kind of going to follow along with your cursor. And then when you stop, you can hover over it and look at the options. So the option here that we're interested in is look. So I'm just going to hover here over the center of the screen, hover over look, click with my left mouse button, hold, and now I can look around. So here I can see this office, I can see the windows, the lights, and here is the outside. Now the best part is you can use the W and S keys to basically navigate around. You can also use A and D to move left and right. So W for forward, S for backwards, and A and D for left and right. Now you can also go through doors. So here we have a door. I can just go through that, and here we're at the elevator shaft and the stairs. So I can just look around there. I can go through the wall again, go to our main area. Now keep in mind, I'm holding my left mouse click all this time, because if I stop, it's going to stop and get back the full navigation wheel. So now I can look, I can go through, see the other office. So here we have this other office. I can go through this door, see the corner office. Yeah, it looks really nice. Now let's move over to walkthroughs. These are really impressive because you can actually generate an animated video inside of Revit. So we have the same building. I'm just going to open up the site plan, and then again we can go to the view tab, and here under 3D view we have the walkthrough. So for our walkthrough, we need to basically sketch it out. I want to create a video where I'm going down the road, looking at the building, and then entering the building. So I'm going to click here once, then click here, 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 and then let's say inside of the building like that. Okay, now I can click on finish walkthrough, and it's going to create this blue line. That's okay. What you want to do is you want to go here into edit walkthrough in order to edit it, but we also want to see it. So go to your project browser, scroll down until you find walkthroughs, and double click to open up your walkthrough. So I'm just going to click and hold the tab and then dock it here off to the side, so I can see what the camera of the walkthrough is seeing, and here I can see the path. So that's what you want to have. Then you can click on the camera, go to back to edit walkthrough, and you can change frames. So you want to go to the previous keyframe. So the keyframes are where you've placed the camera when you were creating the path. And then let's go all the way back to the beginning. So that's here. Here I can already see an issue. I need to go to properties and check off far clip offset. That's the first thing. Then let's make this fine level of detail. Okay. Now let's go back. We need to go back to edit walkthrough. Whenever you make any changes in the model or in Revit, it goes out of the edit walkthrough menu. So anyways, here we can see this camera looks good. We can see it also here in the site plan. Now I do want to change the orientation. So let's go here to our full navigation wheel, and then let's just look at the building like this. Then we can go to the next keyframe. Again, let's look at the building in this case like that. Then we can go to next keyframe, look at the building like that. Next keyframe looks good, and next keyframe looks good. Okay, so once we have all of this set, then we can just go back to the beginning, and then you just want to look at this video here. So let's hit play, and it's going to show us an animated video for this walkthrough which we have created. And there we go. That's pretty much how you create a walkthrough, and then you can always go here to file, export, and you can actually export this walkthrough as a video. And now for our third and final option, let's create a 360 degree panorama 3D view. So for that, what we need to do is we need to go to our model. I'm just going to open up the site plan, and then let's create a simple camera view here in front of the building, looking at the building just like that. I can switch this to fine level of detail so we can see that door. Okay, this is pretty much everything that we need as far as the camera is concerned. Then we need to go to the view tab, and here we're going to find the presentation panel and find cloud rendering, open up the drop menu and click on render in cloud. Once we're here, we get the steps outlined, then let's click on continue, and here we need to basically set up what we want to see. So the view is going to be this, the 3D view 3, that's the one. Then we have the output type, which we want to do panorama. Now you also have stereo panorama. The difference is this is just one view that you can look around on the screen. This is more if you have those virtual reality goggles, VR goggles or something like that. I'm just going to go with a regular one. Then we have the quality. We can go with standard exposure. Yeah, let's just keep it as is. And then here for size, let's see if we can get something bigger. Nope, it's going to require points, which I don't have. So let's go with this one. And then let's click on start rendering. So now it's going to be uploading this scene, and it's going to start rendering it. So here you can see that rendering is in progress. So you can just leave it to render in the background. You can continue working on your model. And once you're done, you can either find the render gallery here, or you can click on that link there. So that's whatever you like. So in this case, I'm just going to open up the render gallery here. And once the rendering process is done and you've opened up your library, you can click on view project. It's going to open it up like this. And this is the result. So as you can see, you can just use your cursor to look around. Here we have the building. Yeah, pretty much nothing in the background, but we do have our building, and you can place multiple camera views like this and render them as panorama inside of the building, so you can show the interior, so on and so forth. And of course you can download this, or you can open this rendering on a phone so you can send it to somebody as a link. Okay, so that's going to conclude the main ways of creating virtual tours inside of Revit. If you would like to get access to all of my Revit project files, like this office building, for example, or any of my other Revit project files, you can find all of them on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.